Okay, we will start. Om Yasmat Jatam Jagat Sarvam Yasmin Yeva Praliyate Yene Tam Dharyate Chaiva Tasmai Jnanatmane Namaha Ishvaro Gururatmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Taittiriya Kasarasya Mayacharya Prasadataha Vispashtartha Ruchinam Hi Vyakyeyam Sampraniyate Om Shanno Mitrasam Varunaha Shanno Bhavatvaryama Shanna Indro Brihaspatihi Shanno Vishnururukramaha Namo Brahmane Namaste Vayo Twameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Twameva Pratyaksham Brahma Vadishyami Satyam Vadishyami Ritam Vadishyami Tanmamavatu Tadvaktaramavatu Avatumam Avatu Vaktaram Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Vedamanuchyacharyante vasinamanushasti Satyam vada dharmam chara Swadhyaya anma pramadah Acharyaya priyam dhanamahritya Prajatantum avyavachetsi Satyanna pramaditavyam Dharmanna pramaditavyam Kushalanna pramaditavyam Bhutyena pramaditavyam Swadhyaya pravachanabhyamna pramaditavyam Deva pitrikaryabhyamna pramaditavyam Matridevo bhava Pitridevo bhava Acharya devo bhava Atithi devo bhava Up to this we saw in this 11th, it's a very long anuvaka. I thought I will recite once, otherwise we may forget this anuvaka. Up to this we saw, I'll recite the balance, then we will continue. Yanyana vadyani karmani Tani sevitavyani No yitarani Yanyasmakagum sucharitani Tani tvayopasyani No yitarani Yeke chasmachreya gumso brahmana Tesham tvayasanena prashvasitavyam Shraddaya deyam Ashraddaya deyam Shriya deyam Hriya deyam Bhiya deyam Samvida deyam Ata yadite karma vichikitsava Vritta vichikitsava Syat Yetatra brahmana Sammarshinah Yukta ayukta Aluksha dharma kamasyuhu Yata te tatra varteran Tata tatra vartetah Atabhya akhya teshu Yetatra brahmana asamarshinah Yukta ayukta Aluksha dharma kamasyuhu Yata te teshu varteran तथा तेषु वर्तेताः येष आदेशः येष उपदेशः येषा वेदोपनिषत् एतदनुशासनम् एवमुपासितव्यम् एवमुचैतदुपास्यम्. सो दिस् ईस् द एण्टैर् 11th अनुवाक. And last class, of course, we saw up to Atithi Devo Bhava. If you remember, I also talked about this father-in-law, son-in-law business. How son-in-law felt that, you know, Sorgatulyo Naranam, Sosharagriham Sorgatulyo Naranam. In-laws, father-in-law's house is like Sorga. This is how he started. And then if he is wise enough, he should be there for 5 or 6 days. Panchava Shad Dinani. If people are not that wise, then the shloka said, Madhu Dahi Grita Varjam. So if you stay beyond 6 days, honey will go, curd will go, and ghee will also go. Varjam is without, Varjitam. Then we saw the last line which said, if we exceeded 1 month, Padaraksha Prayoga. Anyway, that is on the lighter side of the Atithi Devo Bhava, which we saw last class. Anyway, so up to that we saw, which is roughly about 40% of this Anuvaka. And in this Anuvaka, the teacher is really telling so many things to the students. Because a student life is actually the best life. Because syllabus is known, it's so structured. In fact, I set papers here. And, you know, there is so much of uncertainty in the paper. You know, in my operations management course, so much data is missing. So people, some students get very upset and they come and ask me. I tell them outside world is like that. How can you train you for a world which is known to the last bit? So I build it into my course. But student life is always very structured. Of course, there's uncertainty of the grade and all that. But notwithstanding that, we seem to be in a very protected world. Outside world is very different. So this last Anuvaka, which is a convocation address, really brings a lot of issues in the hands of the students. That's why this Anuvaka is long. So Matridevo, Pitridevo, all those are over. Now it starts by saying, Nanyanavadhyani karmani, tani sevitavyani, no itarani. That's how it is starting. So as I have been doing in the past, this translation is very easy. You can take a book and see it. For each Sanskrit pada, there is a translation. We are not interested in that. So let me give a preamble to where are we going now. What is this guru trying to tell the students? We will look at it in some detail. And then, of course, as usual, we will see the mantras. So the next set of teachings, which perhaps we will see today, are two. First thing is, what is your reference frame for life situations? This is a very important question. We don't teach it anyway in our MBA or anywhere. But this is a very important question. What is the reference frame for my life? Suppose I need to resolve something. There are some situations. How do I handle it? What is the reference framework? He is going to talk about that issue. Again, there are some very nice, see, this Anuvaka is so great because it takes you to the thinking process of the people at that time. That's the charm of this Anuvaka. More than anything, it takes you to what were they thinking, their perspective to life. So in this, we will first see that. What is the reference frame for life? If there are situations and I have to need a, you know, a reference book, what is that and how do I look at it? That's one question he is going to actually tell the students. And then comes a grand piece. The mantra is 1.5 lines long. But in that mantra, I uttered it. Shraddaya deyam, ashraddaya adeyam. The A is, when you utter it, is in silence. So it's not ashraddaya deyam actually. Biya deyam, shriya deyam, samvida deyam. It looks so short, but there is the loss of giving. He talks about that. I think we will be able to handle these two in today's class, hopefully. So we look at it, the preamble to this, before we see the mantras. So the question in front of us is, what is an appropriate way to live? We just get out and, we are going to be in the world of Vyavahara. From a student state, which is all textbook, theory, it is all what it ought to be, what is the text, that's why we use the word textbook case. A student life is all about, the know-how, not the know-way or know-what. It is a know-what, actually. So when you step out, there may be issues. So the students must be given certain thought processes. So that is what it is. So just stepping out of this question, in this country, in this civilization, there are only three pramanas. The reference is called pramana. If I have to do something, am I doing right or wrong? What is my pramana? What is my reference? Right? In this country, we are all guided by only three pramanas. The first pramana is called Shruti pramana. Shruti, I have mentioned this several times in my past lecture also. This society is guided by Shruti pramana. Shruti, first class of Taittiriya Upanishad, we saw it in great detail. It's all the Veda. The Veda with all its Vedangas is called Shruti, which is mantras, brahmanas, samhitas and Aranyaka, and the Upanishads, which is at the end of the Aranyaka. This gamut of knowledge is called Shruti, which is apurusheya. You cannot attribute any authorship to it. That's why it's called Shruti, that which was heard, which was not authored, which was heard. So heard is not in a literal sense. See, these English words are all very, very bad to use in describing our Shruti is heard means not, there is a headphone or something. Heard means what I could connect myself to it and then get that idea. That is called, actually the nearest word is Shruti. So anyway, that is the first pramana for us, called Shruti. The second pramana to us is called Smriti Purana, Smriti Pramana, Smritis. So you have Manusmriti, you have Parashara Smriti, you have Agastya Smriti, Narada Smriti, Yajnavalkya Smriti. Yajnavalkya Smriti and Parashara Smriti are very relevant, people tell, for now than Manusmriti. Manusmriti is a little ahead in time, far early in time. Whereas Yajnavalkya Smriti, they came in different yugas also. Yajnavalkya Smriti and Parashara Smriti are even more. So the second body of knowledge, which is our pramana, are smritis. Smritis are authored. Smritis have no authorship, unlike Shruti. That's why you have a Yajnavalkya Smriti. You have a Manu Smriti, Agastya Smriti, Narada Smriti, Vasishta Smriti or whatever. Then you have Dharma Shastras. Right? You have, Bodhayana Dharma Sutras, Vasishta Dharma Sutras, Ashvalayana, different Vedas, Bodhayanas for, Yajurveda and things like Krishna Yajurveda or something. So Dharma Shastras, Dharma, texts written by great. So there is an authorship here, and these are far more voluminous. Why? Because Shruti is very, very concise. Samasa, it is very, very cryptic. It is very concise. It is like Constitution of India, you need only about 100 pages. If you take a font of, 12 Roman, Times Roman 12, Constitution of India is only about 100 pages in a A4 sheet. You want to administer a country with that. So obviously with that 100 pages, what do we do? They are very, very concise. So it has to be expanded. So Smriti is not written out of somebody's imagination. I want to make this point very clear. Manusmriti is not Manu's thinking. Manusmriti is a Manu's attempt to extract this abstract idea in Shruti and put it in a little more detail. He has written it in 2785 slokas in 11 chapters. So each sloka is a duet. So think of 5,500 lines in which he has written it in a particular way. So Smriti. So the second pramana is Smriti pramana. Then we have a third pramana for us, which is called Shishtachara. ಶಿಷ್ಟಜನಾನಾಂ ಆಚಾರ. ಇನ್ ಇನ್ ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಯುನೋ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಲೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಲೀಡರ್ಸ್ ಆಟೋಬಯೋಗ್ರಫೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಮೇ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್. ದೆರ್ ಆರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ಲಿ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್, ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ, ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್, ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಲಾಂಗ್. ಮೇ ಬಿ ದ ಆಚಾರ ಆಫ್ ಸಚ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಶಿಷ್ಟಜನಾನಾಂ ಆಚಾರ, ಶಿಷ್ಟಾಚಾರ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ತ್ರೀ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೇಮ್. ನೌ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಡೂ ಐ ಡೂ ಇಫ್ ದ ತ್ರೀ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್? ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್. ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಮೃತಿ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಶಿಷ್ಟಾಚಾರ? ಯು ನೋ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ತ್ರೀ ಸಿ ಟೂ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್. ನೌ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಟೂ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ತ್ರೀ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್. ನೌ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ ದಿಸ್? ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಥಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್? ಇನ್ ಬಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಂತ್ರ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸಿ. ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್, ದಟ್ ಮಂತ್ರ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟ್ರೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಯಾಂಬಲ್ ದ ಮಂತ್ರ ವಿತ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗಿವ್ ಮಿ ತ್ರೀ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೇಮ್ಸ್, ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಐ ನೌ ಇಸ್ ದರ್ ಅ ಹೈರಾರ್ಕಿ? ಸೊ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಹೈರಾರ್ಕಿ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಹೈರಾರ್ಕಿ ಈಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್, ದ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಶ್ರುತಿ. Nothing other than Shruti. I mean, today's modern constitution in a civilized world, we understand it. Nothing can go against constitution. Supreme Court will finally say, does it violate the principle of constitution? Whether a law applied in income tax or a law applied in right to information or a BBMP rule which decided to collect a tax from you or send a form to you and ask some detail which you don't want to fill, how do you resolve it? Now there is, if there is a conflict, the reference frame for the conflict is a constitution of the country. Like that, this society is driven by Shruti Pramana. I have told it several times in my previous lectures. Why I am saying this is, I have mentioned this in specific context. Now, in Bhagavad Gita, we talked about three types of food in chapter 17. That time I quoted from Chandogya Upanishad. I said, that is the Pramana. You can write off everything. You can scratch off everything and say, if anything is in violation with any idea about food written in Upanishad, go with the idea in Upanishad. We are guided by that. So the first principle is, this cannot, if there is in conflict, our established, they themselves have said it. I will show you some of the Dharma Sutras themselves say that first. I quite often don't find a major conflict between Smriti and Shruti. But I find a lot of conflict between Shishtachara and any of the other two. Look at this. Parashurama beheaded his mother. Parashurama, so what is Shishtachara now? What do we do now? A question can come like that. If Parashurama beheads his head, what do I do about it? Look at Ramayana. There is a lot of debating going on if Valli Vada is correct. Is it proper to send Sita to the forest? You know, in my city, Madurai, our temple is so large. So the outermost prahara of the temple is like any street in any city. It is so huge. So in the south street, if I have to use the word like that, in the south street, year long, nowadays it doesn't happen. Year long, there is a debating club. And what is the topic? Is Valli Vada correct or not? So people, literary giants will come and then thrash it out left, right, center. This is, you know, trying to find whether Shishtachara is correct or not. Or is what Vibhishana did is correct or not. Is Vibhishana correct or you know, Bhishma correct? Now you can cut across, because a very interesting story. What Bhishma did not do and Drona did not do, Vibhishana did. In fact, in Assam I gave a talk. One lady asked me, one Sanskrit teacher asked me this question. Sir, you talked about Dharma. Please resolve this. Is Bhishma, Bhishma is such a great personality and he got perished. Is Bhishma correct or Vibhishana was a traitor? So I said, Dharma Sukshma is very hard, but still whatever little I know, I will tell. I said, let's start from the ground principles. If Bhishma perished, he is on the wrong side. This principle cannot be violated. then Sanatana Dharma is in trouble. So I said, let me start from there. If Bhishma perished, he was on the wrong, he did something wrong. If Vibhishana did not perish, he must be right. So we have to now have hold on to the Shruti Pramana and go, and then I try to explain. In a way, I said, you have to look at it more carefully. I may not have given you the right answer. But point I'm making, Shishtachara, look at Mahabharata. The entire war, Krishna tricked throughout. All great people are killed only by trick. Arjuna, Karna could never have been removed from the war. All others could have been removed. It is impossible to remove Karna from the war. Karna could have taken the hands of Draupadi and gone. Krishna came and tricked there. Draupadi's Swayamvara happened. So if you look, so Shishtachara means Avatara Purushas. Now, because this really takes us to a serious problem now. So what do we do now? And I find this idea of Krishna has been hugely misused in this country. Because they take all wrong things from a Shishtachara and then justify what they are doing. Whether it is, from the romance, or starts from romance to tricking and cheating, for everywhere Krishna is coming. So this question is also there. If Krishna can do, why not I do? You said Shishtachara is one of the Pramana. That's also possible. So all these questions are actually answered by this half a line mantra. Anyway, we'll see the mantra before that. The point I want to make is, as I told you, Ahimsa Paramo Dharmaha. That is in Smriti, not in Shruti. And then Parashurama does something, because in Shankara Bhasha this example is there. So I took this example also. So what do I do now? So the answer is twofold. There are two answers. First resolve this problem, then we'll come to the mantra. The first problem is, it's absolutely foolish to ask this. It's absolutely foolish to go behind and then dissect it in great detail. Doesn't take you. This is what, wise people say. Yes, all these examples I have given. Don't go and then dissect it. You will actually end up in a position which is not going to be anything great for you. There are some Subhashitas also for that. And I don't want to quote. But point is, the first message is, leave that. You need to know, when Shishtachara is Pramana, this is not the Shishtachara that is in Pramana. Because that is in violation with either Smriti or Shruti, you have just forget it. This is the first principle which we should be guided with. The second principle is, that's all right. I am now not interested in finding out why did they do it. The question is more interesting is, why not I also do it? That's a much easier question than this. So let me not now, I will not ask that question now. No, anyway, Krishna did it, let me also do it. Rama did it, so let me also do it. For which one of the answer people give, yes, you can do it under only one condition. And what is that condition? Let me ask you, when can we violate? I will tell you, there are three things. If you pass these three tests, you can perfectly violate. There is one Vakya also somewhere. I am not able to, one Veda Vakya is also there which suggests this. First question is, have you transcended Ragadvesha and the world of dualities absolutely? Are you a person who has transcended the world of duality? Ragadvesha, success, failure, I like it, I don't like it, Sukha, Dukkha. In Bhagavad Gita, we have talked about it so much. The first question you have to ask is, have you transcended the world of duality? Yes, you have passed the first hurdle. Now more or less you are one third ready to violate the rules. Second, because a person who has transcended a raga dvesha, his perspective of the world is very different from the perspective of our world. In fact, the word, see, English is such a poor language. In Sanskrit, if you want to say world, there are several words for it. Jagat is one. Loka is another. You know where loka has come? This is called lochana. I is one of the word for I is lochana. Okay? Aksha, lochana. Now one of the word for world is loka. And it comes from, the lochana and loka comes from two dhatus. One is called lokra, another is called lochra. Lokra means darshane. Lochra is also darshane. So the lochana comes, the seeing comes from this root. The world comes from loka. It's a very interesting word. You know what is world? World is what you see. The world is what you see. You give me a cup of, give you a cup of coffee to three of us. For us, the three are three different things. Our notion of world is very different there. Alokayate. There is a Sanskrit verb called alokayate, who sees. So world means, actually the meaning of world is that what we see. See the power of this word, loka. It's called loka. And insect with two indriyas, its loka is different from the loka for us. An insect with three indriyas, loka is different. An insect with four indriyas, we have insects with one indriya, two indriya, three indriya, four indriya, and we are in the gigantic five indriya. Even within us, each one of us, the world is different. So the world of a person who actually transcended raga and dvesha ought to be very different from my world and your world. So have you passed that hurdle? If you say yes, then there is a second which is related to the other. Second is, are you operating your life in a pure 100%, not 99.999, it's not 6 sigma, it is not even 12 sigma, it is 100%. Are you operating your life in a 100% know what is in it for me mode of living? Not what is in it for me. Keep away what is in it for me. Know what is in it for me. Negative of that. On a 100% 24/7. If you have passed these two hurdles, Veda says, Vidhi and Nisheda is not for you. This world of do's and don'ts, this Smriti, Shruti and all those are actually putting some whole gamut of do's and don'ts. It says, people who have transcended these two, for them none of these apply, because whatever action they take is not for them. It's a much bigger thing which we don't even understand. So that is the answer. So we leave that part now. So we are not there. So let us not look at the wrong things of a Shishtachara and then look at it. So these are all the things to be told to the student. So our mantra says it in about half a line. So we'll now have to see the mantra. But anyway, before that, this is from Bodhayana Dharma Sutra. Look at what this is saying. This is saying, Upadishto Dharmaha, Prati Vedam. In every Veda, all Dharmas are laid out. That is, chapter 1, Sutra 1, I think, 111 or something. Correct? Then what it says, Smartho Dvitiyaha. So if you are not able to see something of what you are looking at in the Shruti, it will be in Smriti. Dvitiyaha. Smartho Dvitiyaha. Tritiyastu Sishtagamaha. So then Shishtachara, that's what it is saying. Your Pramana is Shruti, then Smriti, then Shishtachara. That's what he says. This Vasishta Dharma Sutra, that is the next one, that qualifies it even more. What does it say? It says, Shruti Smriti Vihitaha Dharmaha. The Dharma is properly laid out in a combination of Shruti and Smriti. Generally, the conflict between Smriti and Shruti is less, very rare and less. It is only with the Shishtachara actually. That's why it needs qualification. That's why I talk so much about these examples also. So now it says, Tad Alabe. Suppose I am not able to access Shruti or Smriti. See, there could be situations where we cannot access. Existence is one, accessing is another. If I am in a situation where I am unable to access, is it that I have nothing? Then Shishtachara. This is like saying, I will attend a MBA class in IIM Bangalore, but then for that you need to pass the CAT. And then even after CAT, it is 1:1:8. That is our ratio of taking. We look at some 2,500 students and take some 400 or something. Now if you ask, what do I do? You do some EGMP or something. If you can't do it, there is a MOOC. So there is a massively online open course, open online course, come and take it. So there are, see, this is not there. This is the second best. So please understand, Shishtachara is third best. In the absence of anything, that is the only thing you can do. So that is what it is, qualifying. So all these ideas are folded into the next mantra. Guru is actually telling something. Let us see that mantra. So that question is also there. We will come to it. That's also there in the next, when we look at it, we will. So now this mantra says, Yanyana Vadyani Karmani Tani Sevitau Vyani No Itarani. So that's one part. Then the second part says, Yanyasmakagam Sucharitani Tani Twayopasyani No Itarani. So there are two parts here. It says, Yani Anavadyani Karmani. Anavadyani Karmani means those karmas which are not viruddha to this body of knowledge called dharma. Dharma avruddha, not dharma viruddha. It's dharma avruddha. That is why in Bhagavad Gita chapter 7, in the 10th shloka, in Bhagavad Gita chapter 7, 8th shloka to 11th shloka, in chapter 7, 7th shloka, there is a beautiful shloka. He says, what does it say? He says, Mayi Sarvamitam Protam Sutre Manigana Iva. He says, there is no speck of dust other than me. Correct? He says, there is nothing other than me. Everything in the world is like, you take a long bead. Mayi Sutram Proktam Manigana Iva. Sutre Prokta Manigana Iva. That's what, Na Kinchidasti Dhananjaya. That's what he says. He says, there is nothing else other than me. Now, how do you explain it? He takes the next four shlokas and shows so many things. He says, Balam Balavata Masmi, Tejas Tejasvinamaham. Like that, he goes on giving, how do you understand this concept? There is a beautiful thing he says. Dharma Avruddha Kamosmi. He says, I am in that desire which is not Avruddha to, Vruddha to Dharma. It says, you should not be in conflict with Dharma. That's what he said there. He said, Dharma Avruddha Kamosmi Aham. You can see God in all that desire in which it doesn't, clash with Dharma. I'll give you an example. Suppose I have desire that none of the slum children should go uneducated. That desire is a good desire. He says, you see God there. But on the other hand, if you say, I want to whack a lot of money and buy a 50-80 plot so that I can enjoy, that is not Dharma, avruddha kama. We don't know what kama it is. So you can't see God in that, but you can see God in the other desire. So you can't say all kamas are bad. Dharma avruddha kamosmi aham is what he is saying. So some of those kinds of references are there. So he says that's our anavadhyani karmani. All those acts which doesn't conflict with this pramana, right? Thani sevitavyani, you follow only that. You follow only that. No itarani. So by that what he is implying is, if some of the acts that you have to take, if it is in conflict with smriti or shruti or a combination of that, you are not supposed to do it. Please understand this guiding principle of how do you take, resolve your dilemmas in life or some of the trade-offs and things like that. That's a kind of motherhood statement he is making here. So what he is saying is Shishtachara, the Shishtachara is coming here. Next sentence you see what he is saying. Yani, Yan Asmakagum, Yani Asmakam, as I told you, this Gum is a Yajurveda add to the Im. In Yajurveda, Im always becomes Gum in pronunciation. That's part of the Veda. So it says Yan Asmakagum, this is Yan Asmakam. Im becomes Gum there actually. So Yani Asmakam Sucharitani, he says, I am your guru. In Bhagavad Gita, he said, Yadyad Acharati Sreshtaha Tadyadeva Itara Janaha. Krishna said that. What people asayat pramanam kurte lokastha danuvartate. What he does, people will follow it. Leading by example, all that he said. But here you see what broad-minded these rishis, how courageous they are to say, look at us. We may do some of the things which are not correct. Don't do it. That's what he is saying. Asmakam sucharitani. Sucharitani. Those which qualify into that, which means, please understand, we are not above blemishes. They have the courage to say that. They have the courage to say that we are not above blemishes all the time. You need extraordinary courage to make a statement like that. They say, I am, you better listen to me, I know everything. But Swami Paramarthananda's lecture, when I was hearing, he made a beautiful reference. He said, if you follow a person, 100% letter and spirit, you follow only the person, you will end up in a cult. If you follow a scripture, you will end up in a tradition. This is how he put this idea. The idea he put is, that's what this Rishi is saying. He's saying, I have told so many things to you, but a time must come, you should overstep me, you should outgrow me. Not overstep, outgrow me. Understand, there are areas where if I am not strictly following, you should be able to grow beyond me. That's what is coming through this. So Shishtachara, only as long as it doesn't come in conflict with our Shruti Pramana. That's why he says, Yani Asmakam Sucharitani. Only Sucharitani, not Duscharitani. Duscharitani has lived because no Itarani. Look at this. This Anuvaka is very powerful in communication. I've been saying this. Look at, he could have stopped with this sentence. He could have said, Yan Asmakam Sucharitani Tani Toya Upasyani. By you must follow only the. He could have stopped there. He has added no Itarani. Look at the power of communication here. If you want to unambiguously communicate, you have to tell the negative things also. Because if you are stopped here, it does not preclude the possibility of you also following some bad things. This is a subtleness of communication. This Anuvaka is full of that. There is subtlety in communication. Shraddhaya Deyam. He could have put a full stop there. You are going to see. He said Ashraddhaya Adeyam. He made it watertight. This is called clarity in communication. So no Itarani he put, to make sure that even in sleep, even in your dream, you should not think of a possibility of following a person of a great standing of that act which can go against the Shruti and the Smriti. All those are contained in these two lines that you see here. That's why he says, Yani Asmakam Sucharitani Tani Toya Upasyani. You must follow that. He did not put a full stop. He put a comma and said, no Itarani. Which means, forget, filter the other things. So don't bring Parashurama for beheading the mother. That's not the story there. It's meant for something else. Don't bring, Dronacharya to say, it is good to ask for somebody's thumb for Gurudakshina. No, that's not the issue there. Don't bring Krishna and say, Ashwatthama Hataha Kunjaraha, you tell in silence and kill Drona. That's what he tried. Ashwatthama Hataha Kunjaraha, elephant. Elephant is said in silence. Ashwatthama Ataha Drona lost his concentration. He said kill. Adi. Over. Whole Mahabharata war was like that. So there is a lot of Dharma Sukshma. That's why I am a little worried, because in some of the serials you can't get into this level of discussion. It gives a very different meaning to us. We can get away with anything. It's not. So we need to know what to look when, where. That needs a high level of wisdom. All these, this Rishi is trying to communicate to the passing out students in this. Then he says, Eke chasmachreya gumso brahmanaha tesham toyasanena prashvasitavyam. He says, Eke cha asmat. Asmat is panchami. It's an apadana. Compared to me, compared to us. Asmat shreya, somebody who is superior to us. We read in terms of knowledge, and Brahmana is only knowledge. Brahmana is, all others are newfound things. Brahmana is only knowledge. Poverty and knowledge coexist with Brahmana. That was the kind of a framework which was there for a long time. Anyway, so it says, Asmat shreya brahmanaha. Okay? So those Brahmanas, when they come, what do you do? This is he is giving a particular piece of advice here. So here he says, Tesham Toyasanena Prashvasitavyam. So there are two commentaries available for this. So I have color coded something there. Okay? And there are two meanings I have written. So first part is okay. First part says, there is a very learned person, a very wise person is coming. Or, you are going to the assembly of a person where there is a much wiser, That's up to that Brahmanaha. Now the second part says, what do you do? So there are two ways to understand this. He says, Toya by you, Tesham Asanena Prashvasitavyam. Give them respect. Give them, understand that you need to give them enough respect. Put them in wherever, give them Satkara. That is one kind of a meaning, right? That is what I have written in the second, in the red. What happens is, Tvaya Asanena, Asane, see there are, the Asanena can be split. Sanskrit is a very powerful language actually. Asanena is there. What you can do is up to Asane you can cut it off. So now you have Tvaya Asane, then Na, Na means Nahi, don't. That's the meaning of Na. He is only for emphasis. Na is enough. He is always used in Sanskrit only for emphasis. My favorite example for that is Yada Yada Hi Dharmasya. That he is just to give a punch. He always used Nahi. Hindi mein Oi mein we do the same thing. Abhi. Abhi is Abhi. He is always for emphasis only. So, Tvaya Asane Na. Tvaya Asane up to that is one. Na Prashvasitavyam. Keep them seated. Don't even breathe. Don't even breathe means don't, you know, die out of congestion or something. What it means is, you know, you intensely listen. So don't, you know, it's time for you to take rather than talk. There are some people who say, I'll ask a question, 45 minutes, they will give a background to the question. That's the end of the story. You know, so the if you split it like that, Tesham Toya Asane, up to that you cut it. That means offer, you know, Tesham Asane, they are all in seating. That is the meaning. Tvaya Asane means they are in seating, which means they are in an assembly. So when you are in an assembly of learned person, if you are a little wiser, try to take ideas from them rather than waste your time talking. Na Prashvasitavyam, don't even breathe. Don't even breathe means it's a figurative usage. Means, you know, take. Don't waste your time, you know, wasting your time. It's a great opportunity. Take. That is one meaning that I have written in red. So if you had split it like that, the Na has to be split. Tesham Asane means they are all sitting. At that time, Na Prashvasitavyam. Don't even breathe. Means be in rapt attention and try to gather your knowledge. That is one way to say it. Another way to say is, Tesham Tvaya by you Asanena Prashvasitavyam. Asanena means by an asana. Offer them a seat, give them respect, do satkara. So there are two ways to understand. So essentially the Guru is saying that, you know, in the council of wise people, use that opportunity to, you know, partake that wisdom. That is a nice thing that can happen to you in your life. So try to do that. Give them respect. Understand that, you know, these are people who are need to be, you know, respected. So all those kinds of meanings are part of this kind of a thing. So this part of the Anuvaka has primarily how do you resolve some of the questions that you have, what is your framework, and then a little bit on this. Then he gets into, the Rishi gets into another topic, which to me is a very, very important thing, which is laws of giving. It's so grand. In fact, when I talked about three types of dana in Bhagavad Gita chapter 17, I actually brought this whole mantra there. If you, some of you may recollect, I brought all these mantras there because this really is grand laws of giving. Now, dhanam. If you get into the Indian repository of knowledge, you will find a large chunk of references and subhashitas. I am aware of it. So today 2 hours I spent into some subhashita bandagara and a few, I have some repository of subhashitas. I plunged into it. I brought some shlokas I want to bring. Because you, the kind of perspective you have taken on dana, and that has pervaded into our living so much, you have to be in a village to understand it. You have to be in a village to understand it. If you go to a village, there are, in many places, they would have put some solid stone and rock. You know why? Person who is carrying must be actually, he must get a help to offload for some time. That is a level of thinking. Come summer, you go to any village in this part of this country, you will get buttermilk free. Not 1 cup, 10 rupees. Shramadhanam, all kind. Dana is our living. Dana is our intense life principle. So I will take some shlokas, there are many of them, I will take some of them and then get into the Taittiriyas. Beautifully they have put in very concise format some principles of giving. So dhanam is actually a very natural phenomenon. Right? Because there are so many, look at this. Pibanti nadyaha swayameva na ambaha. A river does not drink its own water. That's so. These are all very figurative usages. It only you have to reflect on this. Don't use your rational mind and say, how can a river drink its own water? In this rational mind with which you will be an utter failure in understanding Indian wisdom. I put 3 videos on it in YouTube. Somebody is interested, you can see 10 minutes, I put 3 videos. What are the challenges in understanding ancient Indian wisdom? I have 3 videos in my channel. With rational mind, if you read, you will prove yourself totally wrong. Please don't do that. Never read any ancient Indian text with rational mind. Again, my favorite example is Draupadi was disrobed. Don't read it from an analytical mind, because if you bring analytical mind as a professor of operation management, I will ask what is the manufacturing lead time for the sari, who is winding it, what is the mechanism to wind it, what is the mechanism to unwind it, is the business process balanced, capacity balancing. This is all you can do when you look at a story rationally. That story is meant for something. Like that, all these shlokas are like that. If you read rationally, it is a laughing stock. That's why Westerners are laughing at our wisdom. Our wisdom is very deep and intuitive. You have to reflect on these ideas in a different way. So it says, Pibanti Nadyaha Swayameva Nambaha. A river does not drink its own water. That's the first part. Then say, Swayam na kadanti palani vrikshaha. This majestic mango tree only makes a trade possible for somebody. It doesn't eat its own mango fruit. That's what it says. Na adanti sasyam kaluvi vari vahaha. The rain does not say, let me take all the sasyas and go, because I am the major enabler of growing all these wheat and rice and all these sasyas, dhanyas. The rain does not say that. Then it says, paropakaraya satam vibhutayaha. People who rise to high levels of their manifestation, vibhuti, and their existence are like this. Paropakaraya satam. That's how they approach their life, is what this shloka is saying about dhanam. In Bhajagovindam, look at Adi Shankaracharya. You know, it is easy to say all these ascetics had nothing, they are all talking about actually, you know, only God. It's not actually true. It's phenomenal amount of social thinking, phenomenal amount of management, so much is there. Shankaracharya, if you take, look at this shloka, it says, Giyam, Geyam Gita Nama Sahasram, Deyam Shripati Rupa Majasana. He says, every day, Sahasranama, Vishnu Sahasranama, Lalita Sahasranama, whatever you can, and Gita, read a little bit of Gita, read Sahasranama. That's the first part. Kayam Gita Nama Sahasram. Dhyayam, do dhyana of Shripati, the Lord of Shri, which is Vishnu. Rupa Majasram, right? So that is what the second line. Then he says, Neyam Sajjana Sanghe Chittam. Get yourself led into a satsanga. Satsanga is Nisangatvam, Nisangatve Nirvo Mahatvam. Already he says, Nirmohatve Nischalatattvam, Nischalatattve Jeevan Mukti. In another shloka he says, but he says, try to find a good company. It does a lot of good to you. And what is the last he said? Deyam Dina Janayacha Vittam. He is a great social scientist. He says, don't, you know, enjoy yourself all by yourself. Take care of poor people a little bit. These are the 4 Nitya Karma he is giving in a very nice, small, sweet little way. He says, Deyam Dina Janayacha Vittam. Share your riches with some poor people. That's a very fundamental thing that this culture, this country has very greatly believed. You will see it in very strong terms in this country, in the countryside, in the villages. That's why one of my colleague, Professor Vaidyanathan, wrote when, you know, Warren Buffet come and said India should know how to give more, he said, you don't know what India is giving. Because the first act of giving is you should not say that you are giving. Beautifully he wrote an article. Hats off to him. He said, what do you know about Indian giving here? I should not say I am giving. It is not the CSR nonsense that we are talking. We should give without knowing. In this country, you know how much every one of us are doing, every parents are doing, I know that. You don't have to go and say, I am giving. So he wrote a fitting article to Warren Buffet in response to what appeared in Hindu. He said, you don't know what charity is very concealed and underground here, you don't know. Huh? No, there is a Western and Indian perspective. I will show you. I have one slide in which I talked about it in chapter 17. I brought this again because it's very, very important, crucial. Anyway, before that, some Subhashitas I want to take. He says, Dhanaya Lakshmi, Sukritaya Vidya. If your knowledge cannot do good to others, this knowledge is of no use. This vidya is no use. Because today the maxim is knowledge is power. Our maxim is not that. Knowledge is purifier. Nahi jnanena sadrisham pavitramiha vidyate. That's what Bhagavad Gita Krishna says. Our culture is knowledge is purifier, not power. Power has a very aggressive and a very, you know, market-oriented language. Knowledge is not power, knowledge is purifier for us. If you are more knowledgeable, you should be purer, otherwise it is not knowledge. It's all avidya, it's not vidya. So he says, sukrutaya vidya, right? Chinta parabrahma vinischitaya. Your chinta, your thought is always about parabrahma. That's how, you know, you should engage most of this thing. Today's chinta, I talked about it a few classes before in Taittiriya Upanishad. It's all about, you know, this wealth management. You know, this gives 40%, 13%, this gives 12%. If I park it here, and this is how we spend a lot of our time. But he says, no. Parachintaya, parabrahma vinischintaya, vinischitaya, paropakaraya vachamsi, right? He says, you must have, you know, your words and deeds are for helping others. All your knowledge is for helping others. Yasya vandya striloki tilakasya eva. A person who has these three attributes. What are these three attributes? He says, dhanaya lakshmi, sukritaya vidya, chinta parabrahma. Right? These three attributes, if somebody has it, this is like the crown of jewel in him. That's what this shloka actually says. It is from Subhashita Suradrumaha, from that text. There is one more. Nasti Vedat Param Shastram. Nasti Matuhu Paro Guruhu. Okay? Nasti Danat Param Mitram. Look at this. It says, your dana can get you. Mahanarayana Upanishad has the same statement. I will show you Mahanarayana Upanishad. Mahanarayana Upanishad says, through dana you can actually win over your enemies also. So he says, nasti danat param mitram. It helps you in many ways. Not only here, in the next world when you go. That's what it says. Ihaloke paratracha. So this is a good investment for your trajectory of life. Life does not get over in one janma. That is not our paradigm. If you believe in that paradigm, then dana becomes very important. Life is not just one, you know, accidental attempt of a parent, and so you spend a little bit time here and go. If that's, life is not so simple. Our paradigm is much robust. Life is a journey. This janma is only one milestone or one comma in your life. There are so many commas in your life. If you have that perspective, then you know how to do, what to do even now. That's why these are very, very important. Look at here. Yudyanti Pashavaha Sarve. All animals know how to fight. It's a basic instinct. As much as you know how to fight, all animals, you may fight for food, fight for job, whatever. But fighting is an instinct of animals. Yudyanti Sarve Pashavaha. Patanti Shukasarikaha. Even a parrot can read. If you tell it, it will keep repeating and it will read in that sense. Right? Datum Janati Yaha Vittam. Saha Shuraha Sacha Panditaha. So if you say I can do all that, you are like animals. I can't separate you on the basis of you are able to fight for your position, fight for your existence, you are able to talk very well. There are enough examples. I can, you know, show it in, you are like a pashu. But if you know how to give, Dhatum Janati Yaha Vittam, right? Saha Shuraha Saha Panditaha is what that fellow is really Pandita. He says he is Shura, is what this thing is saying. Chanakya Niti, I found two nice slokas. They are interesting slokas. He says, Kshiyante Sarvadanani Yajna Homa Balikriyaha. These kinds of danas, he says, they'll perish in their fruits after a while. This is like holiday resort. Your punya is only a timeshare. Once the share is over, you have to come back to this world. It's like a timeshare. So every year 3 days, depending upon how much money you pay. In the same way, all these punya will take you to swarga, but you know, that's why in Bhagavad Gita he said, abrahma bonan kitaha, abrahma, you know, bonan brahma punaravartino janaha, abona brahma kitaha punaravartino juna. He says, hey Arjuna, from brahma to the worm will come back here. The Brahma who does Srishti Karya, he, you know, only thing is his timeshare is, his credit is so large, He'll take a little longer time. He says they will all come here. In chapter 8 of Bhagavad Gita, he said, he'll come back here. So that's what it is, kshiyante. Right? Na kshiyate patradanam abhayam sarvadehinam. Whereas, if you are able to invest on a character, a worthy character, if you can invest, that will perpetuate the chain of charity. That's why in the earlier Anuvaka, he said, Satyancha, Swadhyaya, Pravachanecha. Swadhyaya and Pravachana is one kind of dana here. It is Jnana Yajna. You don't say, I will learn everything and then I am happy. I don't care what will happen to the future generation. This is the problem Indians are deeply immersed in. They don't want, have no respect to say, I have to pass it on, pass the baton to my child. They respectfully go away from the child. Child now wants to look at something from elsewhere. And so this is a selfish thinking. That I will learn good things, but I don't have a responsibility to give it back. If you give it properly, then this shloka says, it is better than the other. Nakshiyate. Patradana is very, very important. That's what he is saying. Then he says, the next shloka is also interesting. He says, there are three things in which you should have satisfaction. There are three things in which you should not have satisfaction. Santosha trishuhu kartavyaha. In three things you should have satisfaction. What are that? Swadare. Spouse. Right? Bhojane, eating, and dhane, wealth. The wealth that you created, your spouse, and the food you eat, try to know that you should have a sense of satisfaction, otherwise you will be in trouble. Try to have a sense of satisfaction. But then he says, Trishu chaiva na kartavyaha. On three things you should not feel satisfied. And what are those three? Adhyayane, this jnana yajna that you go through, it's a lifelong. Don't say stop it enough. Today's education is once you get a job, that's the end of the story. Whereas that's why I said our education knowledge is very different. It is to purify you. Purifying you is a lifetime process. Not just a one time up to a point of getting a degree and getting a job. So adhyayane, japa. You know, that's why he said jayam, you know, rupam, sripati, rupam ajastram. Contemplation, don't stop, don't get satisfied with the contemplation. Do some more meditation. Is what it is saying, and dana yoho. In giving, don't get satisfied. In accumulating wealth, get satisfied, but in giving, don't get satisfied. That's what Chanakya Niti is saying. So there are, this whole idea of dhanam is so ambivalent in our country. So ambivalent in our country, in every ritual you will find. Yajna dana tapa kriyaha. In Bhagavad Gita, there is a shloka in chapter 18. I will quote that shloka. I brought it. Pavanani Manishinam is what Krishna has said. Anyway, we'll see it. So we have all kinds of dana. You have annadanam, kanyadanam, vidyadanam. You have shramadanam. The greatest takeaway from Sikh culture and Sikh ideology is karseva. You go to Gurudwara, you go inside and roll a few chapatis and come. What a grand idea they have. In samaja, if you have so many hands, if you put all, is that society is only the greatest society, not a society in which rights, society of rights. Society of rights will divide society on the basis of strength that you have. An underprivileged have no rights in this country, not only in this country, in the US also. Underprivileged have no rights. If you build a society of rights, that's not sustainable. Whereas look at the shramadana as a concept of society. Go to a Gurudwara and go inside and see for some time and come. Your heart will become very light. I have great regard for them for that. That is the greatest contribution of Sikh culture. Shramadana is also there. So annadana, kanyadanam, vidyadanam, godana, bhudana. You know, when I remembered when my grandfather passed away, on the 12th day when we do a, you know, this, if you read Garuda Purana, you will find this soul, in 1 year there is a journey it goes through. It's a very detailed thing. That's why when people die, somebody dies in house, people read Garuda Purana. I actually read at that time. Because at other times they will not allow me to read. But I was curious now, why should I read? It was a fantastic piece. I didn't read fully. In the 10 days, how much ever I could read. It really prepares the psychology of a person towards a departed soul. So there are so many things written there. And on the 12th day, actually they do what is called Pinda Pradana. See, this Preta actually, the soul, I am in Garuda Purana, it says, after the person is dead, the soul actually keeps rotating here. Okay, it's so much used to so many years, na? So many, maybe 70 years, 80 years, 60 years, whatever. It keeps rotating here. So on 12th day, what they do is, they actually push it. They symbolic, all these, there is a lot of symbolism in all these, but they convey a deeper meaning actually. All our rituals have enormous symbolism, but they actually convey something deeper. So they do what is called Pinda Pradhana. What they do is, in the three ancestors, they push the senior most ancestor and include this. The idea is this Preta now must know that I am now. This is like after you become a competitor, veteran. That means your IPL is over, career is over. Your cricket match is over the moment you sat in the studio and started commenting. The same way, moment this pinda is removed and this pinda is brought in, the Preta will actually go. Sapindikarana. They call it a Sapindikarana, right? And it has, in a different language, it is all corrupted into soundies, Hindi, all the different words they use. It's Sapindikarana is the correct Sanskrit word, the ritual. Now this soul has to now, it has now decided, I have to get out of this place. This is no, not my world anymore. So in order for that soul to go, that day they do a very elaborate dana. I saw it. In fact, I know it so well, because when my grandfather passed away, I was in charge of all that store of those items. Buying also, two of us did. And that, when I read Garuda Purana, I could relate a lot of stuff. You know, chatri, you have a mat, you have a chappal, you have a cup of water, you name what not. In every ritual it is there. Why? Because unless you keep on giving, the idea of giving will never come to you. Because the hardest thing is to take 10 rupees and give here for no reason. Because there is a depletion of money. Hardest thing is to take money and give without any reason. In this country, people could effortlessly do it. Villages, they do it royally. So royally they do. The less educated, they do more royally. So I was a PhD scholar in IIT Madras. So what I used to do is, whenever a staff gets married or somebody, I was a little bit mixing with everyone. So I told them one day, let's not all of us give 20 rupees, 30 rupees, it's of no use. I am willing to, go around. I was in good terms with the faculty also, with the teaching staff, 90. So I used to generally, when once somebody gets married, I'll take a paper. And then I will take it. None of the professors will sign. They'll say, come to me later. I found the trick, their amount were always less. These non-teaching staff were more, some more gracious, or some more, I don't know what it is. I'm saying, less the educated, more the brave they are in doing dana. So these are the kind of dana. Godana, Bhudana, Swarnadana. So many things are there. And Dharma Shastra is so practical, it says you are such a poor person. You have to put a flower, a tulsi leaf and pour some water. That is your dana. But then what we are doing is we bypass everything and come there straight. It says we can't do Bhudana, do Godana. If you can't do Godana, do Swarnadana. If you can't do Swarnadana, you do some copper Tamradana. If you can't do it, you give 1 rupee. Today we have now straight. There is this snake ladder game. So straight we have come here. That vitiates the spirit of giving. So many things are there. All religious rules or rituals that we do are integral part of yajna is only dana. You read Puranic stories, you'll find it. The whole Kathopanishad came only out of that. The genesis of Kathopanishad is only from that. This father wanted to do some yajna because he wanted to achieve something, but this man was so smart, he was giving useless items in dana. So the son caught hold of him, Nachiketas caught hold of him. He found that, in fact, the descriptions are so good in Kathopanishad. It says this cow that they gave has no teeth in its mouth. I forget the Sanskrit shloka. Next class, I will tell you that shloka. So beautifully written. So the boy asked, he found the smartness of the father. So he kept on pestering the father, whom am I going to give me? Well, he was very upset with the fathers. Father got so angry, he said, I'll give you to Yama. But the point is, we do a ishtakami, kameshti if you do ishti with kama, any kamya karma you do, do's and don'ts are very tightly applied. Vidhi and nisheda are very tightly applied. So this boy went to Yamapuri. Otherwise his father's, whatever he deserved will not, that's the genesis of Kathopanishad, everything that comes out of that. So why I'm saying dana is part of our rituals. Today we don't know the meaning of rituals, so we find this is a waste of money. There is a larger principle behind all this. Anyway, we'll see it. So there are some perspectives on dhanam, offering to God. That is why Vivekananda, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, they use the word Daridra Narayana. They said, it's a great opportunity for me to give to a poor. It is not throwing money. It's a great opportunity for me to see God in this poor man. Daridra Narayana is the word that they coined. Vivekananda. Daridra Narayana. You see Narayana in the Daridra. That's the kind of perspective that we have in Dana. Anyway, I think this I'll continue the next. It's already 7:05. There are very crucial differences between a Western thinking of Dhanam. I read a very nice paper. I thought I'll cull out some ideas, which I did long back, 2-3 years back. So anyway, we'll continue that in the next class. Next week, we don't have a class. I'm traveling. So we will meet only on 1st of June. 25th May, we don't have a class.